morning, students.
Yes.
Good afternoon, students. Now, here, today we are learning that today the English grammar, that is lesson number 3, phrases and clauses. Phrases and clauses. So, here in this chapter, we are going to learn that phrases, clauses, and their differences. Difference between the phrases and clauses. These three examples we are going to be learning in this lesson. So, now just see here, dear children, I have written some examples on the blackboard. What is there under a tree? The second example is my best friend. And the third example is at 8 o'clock. What you are getting? These are the group of words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The group of words. But are you getting any meaning in that? See here. Under a tree. What under a tree? It is an incomplete. We are getting some sense. But we are not getting complete meaning. What he or she or it want to say under the tree. See, what is this? My best friend. What? Not my friend, but best friend. What happened in Babel is that we are not getting any the complete meaning of these sentences. See, at 8 o'clock, what at 8 o'clock? 8 o'clock, we are from the school. 5 o'clock, at 9 o'clock, we have to go somewhere. What? We are not getting any meaning. So, these are the group of words. So, what is the definite? What is phrase? Yes, in this only, we have to know the phrase. What is the phrase? See the definition of phrase. A group of words that makes sense. See, yeah, it makes sense. Something under the tree. My best friend, at 8 o'clock, we are getting some sense. But what makes a sense but does not give a complete meaning? It's not giving, we are not giving any complete meaning. So, the definition of phrase is a group of words that makes some sense but does not give a complete meaning is called a phrase. So, just see here, when we say, if you are saying this word, this group of words, when you are saying, a cow is under a tree. Okay, and what is that? Suppose my best friend. What? Mona is my best friend. See, now here, are you getting complete meaning? Are you getting good sense? Yes. You are getting good sense. That is a sentence. Full sentence. That is, now you are getting full meaning, complete sense. So, see, now what is that at 8 o'clock? That is 8 o'clock. What 8 o'clock? She will come at 8 o'clock. Now here, you are getting the complete meaning. So, what is see? Here, the phrase is the group of words that gives some sense but not the complete meaning is called a phrase. And then we come to the second part, that is clauses. What is clauses? What is clauses? A group of words making some sense. Pay attention. A group of words making some sense and containing subject and verb. Subject also and verb also. In the earlier lesson only, what we have learned? Subject and predicate. Yes, good. That is the in the clause, a group of words making some sense and containing subject. Very important is that subject and verb is very much important. He is called a clause. See here, now, what is now here once again I am saying? In the clause, phrases not giving complete meaning, we are giving only the sense, but in the here, no, where is the sub verb here? Verb? What is the verb? Verb is an action verb. So, here, a group of words like making sense and continuing subject and verb. Subject and verb is very important in the clause. that gives a complete meaning and a verb is there, then only we can say. So has subject and a verb here. So we have learned only the phrases, clauses and their differences. Now we will learn, now here we are going to learn the types of clauses. Now dear children, we learn the types of clauses. Types of clauses, there are two types of clauses. Dependent clause, here we can say the dependent clause, we can say the main clause, or we can say the principal clause. The three names are there: dependent, independent, main and the principal. What is principal? Principal is a main. We see in our school, the principal. Principal madam is a head. So the same way, the principal clause, the main clause. That's why we are saying the main clause. And it is independent. Independent, see, we are India is an independent country. We are not depending on other country. That is called the independent. We are not depending any other country, that is called the independent. So we can say the two types of clauses, independent clause, or we can say main clause, or we can say principal clause. The second one is dependent. Dependent clause, or we can say the subordinate clause. Depend. If we are depending on you, dear children, you are depending on your parents. So you are dependent. So that is the meaning of dependent. Means in the one sentence, one dependent clause is there that we are going to learn the sentence. We have to know. So dependent and the subordinate. The second we can see the subordinate clause. Now see the, what is the definition of the definition of independent clause? The these sentences contain a subject and a verb. Here also, subject and a verb in both the clauses, dependent clause, independent clause and dependent clause, in both the clauses there is subject and it contains the subject and a verb, both the things. See, these sentences contain a subject and a verb and they give complete meaning. Main principle, when in the sentence, when the subject and the verb is there and then it gives a complete meaning, that is called a principal clause or independent clause. The second one is dependent. These sentences contain a subject and a verb. In this clause also, subject is also there and a verb is also there, but does not give the complete meaning. Subject is also there, verb is also there, but doesn't give the complete meaning is called, means this is a dependent. Book is sitting on the dependent. That's why it is not giving the complete meaning. So here, dependent. Yet is sitting on the dependent. So what is that? Just see, I have given you an example. One example, you were in the party. You were in the party. Now, this dependent clause, what the example I have given? When I come home. See, I, subject, come, verb. Are you getting? Subject behave, verb behave. Both the things are here. Here also, subject is also there, verb is also there. Subject is also there, verb is also there. Right? Giving the complete meaning. See here, giving the complete meaning. You were in the party, to party, hey. When I come home, I, subject, come, verb. But still we are not getting more. When I come home, what when I come home? I slept, I went somewhere again, I washed my, myself and got ready for bed. What is that? Not getting the complete meaning. Now, you see, when these two sentences means dependent clause, dependent clause and independent clause, when you are mixing together, what happens? When I came home, you were in the party. Are you getting the full meaning? Yes. I can say you got the full meaning. Now, see, when I came home, means one dependent clause and one independent clause mixing together, we are getting full one sentence. Full one sentence. Now, see the second example. She also read aloud an essay. She also read aloud an essay. This is which clause? Independent. अपने आप पे वो सही है. ये किसी पर निर्भर नहीं है. ये आत्मनिर्भर है. Nowadays मोदी जी से एक आत्मनिर्भर. So this is अपने आप पे वो निर्भर है. That is called independent. And that you had written. What is this? If you don't read this sentence, read this sentence only. You are getting dependent. ये किसी के ऊपर तो भी depend है. निर्भर है. That you have written, what that you have written, see, that you have written, she also read aloud an essay that you had written. The main thing. Now, the types of clauses, independent, dependent, we have seen the examples also. See these, dependent and independent clause makes a sentence. This is very important. Dependent and independent clauses make a sentence. In complete sentence, there you can see the dependent clause also, and you can see the independent clause also, and then mix together make a sentence. Now, two more examples we'll see, and we'll finish this chapter. What is that? Now, dear children, you just tell me which is dependent clause and which is independent clause. Before you go to bed, are you getting any meaning? Before you go to bed, getting meaning? You have to finish your work. If you see, if you don't see this, okay? Before you go to bed. Now you read this. You have to finish your work. Are you getting? Before you have to finish your work. If suppose your mother is saying you have to finish your work. Are you getting the complete meaning? Yes, you are getting complete meaning. Means here, this you have to finish your homework. That is not depend on others. It is completely independent. अपने आप में full meaning आपको पता चल रहा है. So that is independent clause. Independent clause. Of course. Now see this. Before you go to bed. Yes. This is depend. This is depending. This depending on this. When you are getting reading this, it's depending. Means you are getting the meaning with including this sentence. So that is a depending clause. Now here. Second one, what is that? After months hard work. After months hard work. Are you getting? No, you are not getting any meaning. So of course this is, now if you are saying, if you don't see this sentence, and you will see, he finally got a award. He finally got a award, you are getting complete meaning. So this is an independent clause. And this is dependent clause. I think so, dear children. You got very clear all with these examples. I think so. I hope you understood this lesson. What we have learned in this lesson? First, we have learned the phrases and clauses. So, phrases, the definition of phrases with example, and the clauses, clauses. What is the phrase? Phrase is a group of words. Give what? Not giving contains the complete meaning. Clause having the subject and verb. And gives a complete meaning is called a clause. What is the difference between the phrase and clause that we have learned? Yes. Phrase having no verb, no subject. Very good, children. And what about the clauses? with the examples we have seen, and we have seen the main thing is here, dependent and independent process makes a sentence. Dependent and independent process makes a sentence. A few more examples that we have seen in this, I think so. Hope you understood very well.